wanna be a rock star. Tonight I'm gonna party like a rock star. Tonight I'm gonna make you scream my name. Rock the stage, ain't no shame in my game. I'm a rock star.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. On behalf of the organizer, the Sri Sathya Sai Organization of Singapore, I welcome you to the Human Values Drama Festival 2012. My name is Prashant, and this is my co-host.
I'm Rohit. Love, truth, right conduct, peace, and nonviolence. These are basic human values at the very core of our existence and are interrelated and inherent in every human being. The Human Values Drama Festival is organized for the sole purpose of promoting the practice of these very values in our community in a very secular fashion through creative expression. The organization believes through developing the powers of discernment and greater alertness, the young person becomes more proactive, making inner choices rather than simply acting from habits, unquestioned.
Exactly, Rohit. And now, before we begin, I'd just like to make a few house announcements. The first announcement is for all of you to kindly keep your phones to the silent mode. And the second announcement is that there will be no flash photography or videography allowed during today's performance. We have our official photographer and videographer who will be providing the school with the video and the photos after the event. And now, without further ado, may I please invite the President of the Sri Sathya Sai Society of Singapore, Mr. Sriram, to deliver his welcome address. Mr. Sriram, please.
Dr. and Mrs. Ravindran, students, teachers, and distinguished guests. Good afternoon and a warm welcome to all of you. On behalf of Sri Sathya Sai Organization of Singapore, I take pleasure in welcoming each and every one of you. I realize this is the month of Ramadan, and a number of you may be fasting, yet you have made this effort to participate in today's festival. I really appreciate that effort. We also recognize that as students today, you face a lot more pressure, academic pressure, a variety of other pressures, more than our generation has faced. And it's really appreciable that you're able to take time and prepare and present and work on this human values drama on behalf of your schools. Appreciate that. In Singapore, our founding fathers and all of us have worked hard to make this our country a first world economy. We have pursued excellence in so many areas of our society, be it academic, be it the business, be it in sports, in a variety of areas we have pursued human excellence. To achieve human excellence completely, the next frontier for us is human values. Human excellence is not possible without human values. Hence, the need of the hour for Singapore and worldwide is human values. Every culture in the world teaches us human values, every culture. At the core of them all, the most of the human values are universal. They're very similar. Yet, in pursuit of material comforts, the modern man has overlooked these human values. Our founder, Satya Sai Baba, has since 1940, for 70 years, has taught students and adults alike the essential human values based on such simple universal values like the MC mentioned of love, truth, peace, right conduct, and non-violence. Millions of people around the world have benefited from these teachings. His teachings on human values have been adopted in over 180 countries around the world. And there are 140 schools set up to promote these human values around the world. Our organization is not in the business of promoting any culture. Our objective is in the awareness and practice of the universally accepted human values. We learn human values and try to apply them. While doing so, the one thing that is very, very important for each one of us to practice is the harmony of thought, word, and action. That means what I say should be what I'm thinking, and what I do should be what I say. It sounds simple, but it's very difficult to do. Like, for instance, I might go to my friend, my classmate, and say, hey, your t-shirt looks very good. But I may be thinking, no good. Now, that's not harmony. That is not practicing human values. So as we start to think pure, talk pure, and then do the pure actions based on the human values, that is when we are actually practicing the harmony in ourselves. And without harmony inside us, we cannot build a harmonious society around us. All of you have put in tremendous effort to understand human values, to internalize them, and express them in the form of this drama in the drama festival. And it's your first major step you're making towards human excellence, towards your own excellence. That's an investment you're making into yourself. Some of what you've learned, some of what you've internalized will stay with you and act like a compass that will guide you throughout your life. And not only you become a beacon showing the way to friends around you. And in this process, you help create a better society, a better Singapore. And that is the expectation, that is the reward we as an organization is looking for in organizing this event and in inviting all of you to take part in this event. Enjoy the afternoon, and for the participating teams, best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sriram, for that terribly insightful speech to us on the importance of human values. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we are ready indeed to start the competition, but just before we do that, let me introduce to you our distinguished panel of judges.
Of course, Rohit. Our first judge for today is Miss Nora Samosir. Miss Nora has done extensive work in Singapore with companies such as Theatre Works, The Necessary Stage, Singapore Repertory Theatre, Cake Theatre, Action Theatre, The Theatre Practice, and Theatre Ekamatra, as well as performing in venues in cities such as Edinburgh, Dublin, Napoli, Delhi, Busan, Perth, Jakarta, and Kuala Lumpur. Nora has a postgraduate diploma in voice studies from the Central School of Speech and Drama, London. She is currently a lecturer in the Department of English Language and Literature at the National University of Singapore, where she lectures in theatre studies and teaches voice production. Our second judge for today is Chris Jensen Bio. Chris is a first-class honours graduate from Singapore's LaSalle College of the Arts, founder of two social enterprises and a full-time member of the Ground Up Initiative. In 2011, Chris founded Kinetics Enterprise LLP, a social enterprise that uses performing arts to assist NGOs and government to create inspiring engagement in the area of environmental and social education.
Next on the list, we've got Geraldine Wee. She's had 8 years' experience writing for feature films, dramas, documentaries, corporate videos, complete concept proposals for TV, drama series, TVCs, as well as copywriting for print. Amongst her large canon of work, Geraldine produced and wrote for Creative Youth Exchange 2006, which is an infotainment come reality program comprising 2 episodes. During her time at Big Communications, she also wrote and worked on the production of MDA's interactive digital media promotional video. Ladies and gentlemen, Geraldine Wee, please.